The question and answer you may find in any book, many books. Only thing is that we should develop a thinking that how to solve it, right? Seeing something solved there and then copying it is a different thing. Thinking oneself is required. The two nearest harmonics of a tube closed at one end. What type of tube it is? Closed at one end, open at one end. Okay. There are two nearest harmonics, means one harmonic and then the next harmonic. What is the frequency difference? 220 to 260. Okay. If we see the harmonics, what is the formula we have for the harmonics for the closed? Do you remember? The frequency of nth is equal to n times. Is it correct? No? Please concentrate, it's not correct. Why it is not correct? What type of tube it is? Yes, for that what did you know? Yes. 2 and minus 1, new 1. Okay. Now, tell me one thing. In this, what type of harmonics we have? Even or odd?
Odd.
One harmonic, one sound, and after that other harmonic, other sound. In which, between the two, how much is the difference? Don't see here. What is the difference? That is 2, like this. First we find, when we put it 1 here, new 1. What is the third, next we find? What is the difference between the two? 2 multiplied by the fundamental frequency. 2 multiplied the fundamental frequency is the difference between two adjacent harmonics. Done. Double of the fundamental frequency is the difference. What is the difference? 40 is the difference. That is equal to what? So how much is new one? That is answer. Got it? Again, remember the feature. You see, I have seen neat questions in all previous years. What happens there? That they don't go for very difficulty level number 3. No. But what they go for is the detail. For that, what they expect you, that you have studied each and everything and you remember each and everything by the features. That is your test. Difficulty? No. There is no difficulty here. But if you don't remember, if doesn't click to you that the difference between first, second, second, third, third, fourth, any two, how much is the difference? Two new one. And that difference is given here. So new one is very easy to find. 60 minus 20 divided by 2. That gives you the fundamental frequency. Is that clear to you? Okay. So what should be our answer? 20. This is the right answer. Okay? Now, we go to the next question. Please wait. What is this question all about? Yes, the frequency heard by a driver, and both the cars are in motion. One car is producing the sound, other is listening it. Now, write down that formula, what we remembered, and let us apply that. The frequency heard by the second car is equal to frequency of the original car multiplied by a fraction velocity of sound. And here, velocity of sound. What do we write here? Velocity of observer. And here, velocity of source. Now, they are approaching or they are moving away. Two cars moving in opposite direction, approaching. So what will happen to frequency? Frequency will? So what should we keep here? Numerator plus, denominator
minus.
Now do it. Put the values and see what it comes to. What is the value of original frequency? 400. What is the velocity of observer? 16.5 is the observer and 22 is the source. So we write here 16.5 and here 340 minus 22. This is velocity of the source. Okay. Any correction? These are the four options. How much? 448. Option D. Correct? Everybody could do it? So please remember again, we will write this formula and whether it is increasing or decreasing, according to that we will use the sign. Right. Now we go to the next question. It is same type of question what we did earlier. A siren emits a sound, okay, moves away from an observer. Here is an observer and here is the source. Observer and source is moving away from the observer. The source is going in this direction. And where he is moving towards a cliff. Here is a hill. There is a cliff. And he is moving in this direction with a speed of 15 meter per second. Okay. And it has a siren 800 hertz. That is the frequency of this. And he hears it. How he hears it? One is direct and one is through echo. This question is about which sound of the observer, which he is hearing direct or through echo?
Echo.
That means sound goes here, then there is a echo and he is hearing this sound by echo. Right? How much is the frequency of this sound? Same formula, the frequency heard nu by the observer is equal to nu by the source with a fraction. This is velocity of sound plus minus velocity of observer plus minus velocity of source. Now you have to decide whether they are approaching or they are moving away. That is why this question is given. So that you decide in hurry that they are moving away. Okay, listen. If this distance is equal to x, initially when he starts, how much is the total distance sound is traveling?
2x.
When he goes here, then how much is the distance? Less or more?
Less.
When he reaches here? Less. When he reaches here?
Yes.
So distance is increasing or decreasing?
Decreasing.
So the distance is decreasing. What will happen to frequency?
Decreasing.
Frequency will?
Decreasing.
This is the catch. You understand? The word they are using what? Moving away. But when he is moving away, he is coming closer to it. Because what is the path of sound? This is the path of sound. And when he is going in this way, he is coming closer. Is it clear? So, what formula we should use for increase of frequency? And for increase, what we are going to do? This. Now, what is the velocity of observer?
Zero.
if velocity of observer is zero, this is gone. Now, do it. Yes, how much it comes to? 800 and? See this question. A rope of length L, mass M1, hangs vertically from a rigid support. A block of mass M1 is attached, block mass M2 is attached to the free end. A transverse pulse of wavelength lambda 1 is produced at lower end. The wavelength of the pulse when it reaches the top changes. So it will change then lambda 2 by lambda 1. It changes to lambda 2. So the lambda 2 divided by lambda 1 is which of this ratio? It is a little strange type of question. See the diagram. This is the rope and what is its mass? M1. Where is the mass located of any hanging body? Where is the mass located? At center of mass. Where it is located? So here, how much is the mass hanging? Now, a block of mass M2 is attached to free end here. M2, right? A transverse wave of wavelength lambda 1 is produced at the lower end. Here we pluck it. When we pluck it, a wave goes from here. What is the wavelength of this? Lambda 1. When it reaches here, what is the wavelength? Lambda 2. What is the ratio of lambda 1 and lambda 2? This we have to find. Now, do you understand the question at least?
Yes.
Now you have to put approach. How do you think why there should be a change in lambda 1 and lambda 2? Why there should be a change in lambda 1 and lambda 2? Pardon? Because mass, okay. Is there any relation of lambda with mass? When I ask a relation of lambda with mass, please remember, this may be a relation with lambda, this may be a relation with frequency. Because frequency and lambda, we know the relation. Frequency into lambda is V, lambda is equal to V upon nu, nu is equal to V upon lambda. So any formula you know, which has mass in it and frequency or lambda anything. For a string, you know the formula? V is velocity of the transverse wave. How much is that? Very good. V is equal to root T by M. Now, this V is equal to frequency into lambda. So, what is frequency? No, what is lambda equal to? 1 by frequency and root T upon M. What is this? Tension. And this is mass. Okay. Now, can you make two equations? One for lambda 1 and one for lambda 2. What is changing at this point and at this point? What thing change? The answer is tension changes. What changes?
Tension.
How tension changes? Look. Please look here. this is center, M1 is here. If I hold the rope here, how much is the mass hanging from this? Only if I hold it here. So here the tension is equal to M2G. Here how much is the tension? M1 plus M2G. Understand? So here tension is equal to M1 plus M2. And here the tension is M2G. Okay. Now please do it. Lambda 1, tension 1. Lambda 2, tension 2. And then divide. Which comes?
A.
A?
Yes, sir.
How many have got A? Right. So many people cannot be wrong. So A is the right option. Is everybody able to do? Or any doubt? Lambda 1 is equal to. What you have written, lambda 1 is equal to? 1 upon nu. Or I will write it this way, that lambda is proportionate to root T. This is constant, this is constant. This is what? Please be clear, what is this M? Mass per unit length of the rope. That is same all over. Right? This is not the mass which is hanging. This is the mass per unit length of the rope. So that is constant everywhere. Right? Hanging masses are which? M1 and M2. Now, nu is also constant. So lambda is proportionate to T. So lambda 1 is proportionate to M2. Okay. And lambda 2 is proportionate to M1 plus M2, divide the two. Lambda 2 divided by lambda 1 is equal to M1 plus M2 divided by is it correct? Option? A, B, C, D. Oh, this is M1, this is M1. Right? Okay. How could you know it is A? Everybody said it is A. Okay. See it once again. Please. Silent. See here. This is for the open pipe. For the open pipe, second overtone. Second overtone means third harmonic. First harmonic is V upon 2L. Second is 2V upon 2L. And third is 3V upon 2L. V upon 2L is basic frequency. So this is second overtone, which is third harmonic. This is for the open pipe O. Right. Now, for the closed pipe, overtone. What is the formula of overtone? 2N plus 1 into nu 1. Basic frequency. And what is the basic frequency of open pipe? Sorry. Closed pipe. V by
4L.
Yes, that will also change. V upon 4, and this is given quantity L. What is V? Velocity of sound. What is V? Velocity of sound. Therefore, these two V are same. Understand? So if there is necessary, we can cancel out. Now, the question says that both these frequencies are same. So we can make an equal between the two. Let's do it and find the value of capital N. This is 2N plus 1. How much is the value of N here? Which overtone it is? First, 1. So this is 3V upon 4L. This is equal to 3V upon 2 small L. So L is equal to the length of open pipe is equal to 2L, the length of closed pipe. So our answer here will be B, 2L. Got the relation? So which are the important words in this question? Overtone. What we have to remember, the formula for overtone in the closed pipe is plus and not minus. So this mistake should not be there, and we must remember the two formula, that is overtone in the open pipe, overtone in the closed pipe, right? So this is a very simple this method. So you must be careful that this plus minus we should not change, otherwise there will be loss. So now see this question. Three sound waves equal amplitude have frequencies n minus 1 and n plus 1. All three goes to the same medium and they superimpose to give beats. Why they should give beat? Because their frequency is very close to each other and have the same amplitude, they give the beats. Now, how many beats? What is the formula for beat? Or number of beats is equal to difference in the frequency. So these two will give how many beats? These two? Okay. So how many beats will you hear? 1, 2, 3. And how much this will give? 2. N minus 1 to N plus 1. So how many beats we are going to hear per second? Yes, anybody? Try to imagine it. How many? You see? Please listen here. How much beats these two will produce? One per second. In 1 second, this gives a loud sound. In that 1 second, these two also gives a loud sound. Both loud sound come together. How much will you count? One or two?
One.
Right? So, these are giving a whistle. This is also giving a whistle at the same time. So, how much will be that?
One.
That is one you will count. N minus 1 to N plus 1. That should be 2 beats in 1 second. Okay. Now, what should be the volume of the beat? This is giving volume V, say any volume. This is giving same volume. Both are giving at the same time 1 beat. So how much is the volume? Double. For this, amplitude will be only one wave amplitude. For this one wave, the total will be two waves. You see, these two are giving us a wave which is this much. These two are giving one beat which is again this much. So this amplitude plus this amplitude makes it double the amplitude, 2A, and its power if you have done or not. Its power will be square of the amplitude. This is that one beat, because of this and because of this, which are coming together. Now, these are the, these two are giving two beats of which amplitude? Here and here, A and also A. But these two are separate at the different time, so they don't come at the same time. How much intensity it has? How much intensity it has? These are the two separate one. This is the one. How much intensity? So during that 1 second, what are you hearing? I tell you, during that 1 second, how many sounds you are hearing? This is one, this is two, this is three, this is four, this is five, this is six. What will you notice? That one. Because this has got amplitude A by 2, A by 2, A by 2. These two combine, this makes A. But two times in 1 second, separate times. And here you get A, here you get A, the total become amplitude 2A, which gives the intensity 4A square, four times. So there are so many sounds like now you are hearing. Yes? So many sounds. But what you are listening? My sound. This is 4A square. That is all half A square, 1/4 A square, like that. So how many beats we are listening?
One.
One. Right. So that is our answer for that. Okay. This you have done earlier, almost same. Tell me the formula relations. The fundamental frequency of the closed organ pipe is length 20 centimeter. What is the formula you will write? Velocity upon 4 length is equal to frequency. This is? Okay. The fundamental frequency of the closed pipe. Closed pipe. Right. Is this is equal to second overtone of an organ pipe. Second overtone is third harmonic. For third harmonic, what we can write? 3 V upon 2 L. So they are equal. It is given that they are equal, and with this you will find the value of small L. Yes, L comes to be 120 centimeter. So this waves in the air pipes and on the string. That is very common in your examinations. Doppler's effect is very common. Beat, there may be some questions, and let us see some more. Please see this question. A source sound S, observer O. Both are in one line. S, O. Source is producing a sound with a frequency. Where is the frequency given? 100 hertz. And he starts moving, but not in the direction of O, but in a direction which makes 60 degree to O. And he is moving in this direction, 19.4 meter per second. Observer is at rest, it's not moving. What is the frequency as heard by the observer? We know the frequency heard by the observer. We remember the formula. This is frequency by source, and there has to be a ratio sound sound. This is velocity of sound, velocity of sound, plus minus observer and source. Now here, are they coming closer to each other or moving away? They are initially coming closer to each other. Up to some distance, after that the distance will increase. When the distance will increase, when this distance become equal to this, there will be equilateral triangle. After that it will go away. But initially it is, yeah, this distance and this distance, SO and this S dash O, which is smaller. S dash O is smaller. That means the distance between the two is decreasing, right? So what will happen to frequency?
Increase.
Frequency will increase. So this is plus, this is minus. Correct? Now, what is the rate of distance decrease? It is going in this direction, not in this direction. This velocity is given 19.4. Can we take it as velocity of approach? No, we cannot take it. And it is very convenient. All of you are just thinking that what we should take. That is, yes, component of this velocity in this direction. That will be velocity of approach. Relative velocity between the two. And how much will be that? V cos 60. How much is cos 60?
1/2.
So, that is velocity of source. What is velocity of observer?
Zero.
Now you make it. Apparent frequency by observer. How much it comes to?
102.
Let us see. Oh, options I have not written. Options are 103. So we will take it as 103. Okay, this is how it will be done. So here is a string which is divided into three segments. We don't know what are the lengths, maybe same, maybe different, something. It has to be different because the frequencies are different. Okay, here. So it is, if we hold it here, this is one segment, and click it, it will make a sound. The sound of that frequency is N1. These two, we press like this and click it. It gives a sound of frequency N2, and when we hold this as a node, this as a node, click it, it gives the frequency N3. Now, in the other case, we remove this and this. The same length is there, and now we click it. It gives the frequency N. What is the relation between this N, N1, N2, and N3? Right? The total length is same. Now, this relation, they have given us four options. It may be either of one. So, what do we know? The natural frequency of the string, that is known to us. What is that formula? What is common in these two? The common thing in between that is that it is the same string. The total length is same. It is the same string. Tension is same. Small m?
Same.
Right. T and m are same. So various expressions made by T and M can be cancelled with each other if necessary. So we will try to make expression with that. Now, what is the relation of frequency with T and M? Frequency is equal to 1 by lambda okay. Now, if this is length L1, please relate to L1. Relate to L1. You have done it in the string. This is how much? V upon how much? V upon 2L. Remember? And how much is V equal to? Even if we write V, please remember, the same wire is there. The velocity in this, velocity in this, velocity in this, velocity in this. All is same. Okay. So, this we can write as V upon 2 L1. Right? Clear? Now, what is the frequency 2? And 2 is equal to V upon 2 of L2. Clear? You remember, if we have one wire of length L, the first frequency, fundamental frequency N1 is given by V upon 2L. Consider only this length. So what should be the frequency? V upon 2 into L1. That is the frequency of the first wire alone. Frequency of the second wire alone, V upon. Frequency of the third one, okay, right? Now, this is L1, this is L2, this is L3, and this is total length L, and this is frequency M. What is the relation here?
N is equal to L1 plus
N. N frequency is equal to V upon 2L. Right. Any other relation? Yes. Please remember that relation, that L is equal to. Right? Total L is equal to L1 plus L2 plus L3. Here, L1, L2, L3. V, V, V. So let us do one thing. Divide both sides with V. Can be done?
Yes.
Now, L upon V. L upon V is equal to what? 1 upon 2N. Right? So this we can write as 1 upon 2N. This L 1 upon V. This is 1 upon. Two divide by two both multiplied with two on both sides. You get this equation. Match it here. A. So this is option A. The number of possible natural oscillations of air column. Natural oscillation when the resonance is given, right? Closed at one end. Closed at one end. Do you have any formula for harmonics? First, second, third, fourth. What is that formula? It is frequency of nth harmonic is equal to 2n minus 1. This is what? V upon 4l. What is the maximum frequency we can get? 1250. Below this, there can be many frequencies. What should not be above? What should not be crossed? 1250. Suppose we are getting it 1250. Then what should be the number of n? Please find out. V is equal to 340. L is equal to? Okay, let's do one thing. Please listen here. Let us change the strategy. If we want first, what will be that frequency? How about will you put here? This is 340 upon? How much will be that? Please calculate. Frequency 1. How much we will get?
1.
How come? 340 divided by 4 of this. Oh, this is centimeter. Convert it into meter. That will be 100. Right. So first you are getting how much? Please find the second one. Put it 2. This is 340 upon. If you put it equal to 2, how much it will be?
300.
Pardon?
300.
Put it equal to 3.
500.
If you put it 3, then? 4. Pardon? 7. 5. 5. 9. 900. 6. 6 is? 1100. 7.
1300.
Not required. Not required. So, how many you get?
6.
6 frequencies are possible below this. So, that is your answer. Is there any? Yes. Got it? If you put this value here, you will not get the value of n. What you will get, n is equal to 6 point something. Maybe. So, this is a better way. But it will, once you have calculated 100, after that it becomes very easy. Just 5 seconds, and you can write it. So, how many frequencies are possible? 6 frequencies are possible. Let us suppose this is the road, car is here and it is moving with a speed of 18. Motorcycle is here and this is also moving in this direction with a speed of 36 km per hour. Please convert it into meter per second. 18 is equal to 5. So I write here 5. And this is 10 meter per second. Okay. Both are moving in this direction. Who is the source of honking? Car. And what is the frequency? 1392. This is frequency of the source. Now, he is the observer. What is the frequency heard by observer? Please find out. Are they approaching each other or going away from each other? That is why this confusion has been created for you. What? Approaching or going away?
Approaching.
He is slow, he is fast. So they are approaching each other. The frequency will increase or decrease?
Increase.
Right? Now make the formula. Observer, source. observer, sound, source. What will you keep? In this you will keep plus, and here you will keep minus. Right. What happens when we have a situation that the two objects are coming close to each other? What is happening to the distance? Decreasing. In this case, what's happening? They are going in the same direction. The distance is still decreasing, but the velocity has, direction has reversed. Therefore, this direction will reverse here, but it doesn't fit in our rule. Actually, I told you in the morning that this is a shortcut, not the actual one. What is the actual formula? If you would like to know, the actual formula for this is V minus VO, V minus VS. Both are negative, and we go by sign convention. Sign convention. Now, what is this sign convention? This sign convention, please listen, it will take 1 minute and you can understand, there will never be any mistake after that. Generally, I teach by this method. Sign convention is what? Put sign of sound velocity as positive. Take sign of sound velocity as positive. In this case, this direction is taken as positive because car is the source, here is the observer. So this direction is what? Positive. Right? Now, I want to write here velocity of sound. This is 343. Okay. Velocity of observer. How much is the velocity of observer? 10 in this direction. What will be its sign? Minus. So this will be minus. What is its value? What is its value? Sorry. And what is its value? Source? Minus 5. What is this? 343. So this is 343 plus 10. This is 343 plus 5. Yes, this is the right method. Now you do it. Getting this? This is what? C. So, if it is not much inconvenient to you, please write this as your basic formula. Again, I will make it clear. The correct formula, the appropriate formula, which never fails, is apparent frequency as observed by observer is equal to, the ratio is velocity of sound minus velocity of observer minus velocity of source. Relative velocity of observer, relative velocity of source. But whenever we put these velocities, what we should find out? Sign convention. What is the sign convention? The sound velocity has a sign positive. If this is the source honking, and he is the listener. Which way is our positive direction? This way. Then its velocity will be plus 5, its velocity will be plus 10. If he has the horn and he is the observer, this is the sound velocity direction. So this is minus 5, this is minus 10. Remember? So sound is always to be taken as in positive direction. Rest everything has to be given a sign according to that sign. Now there will be no mistake at all, because the very famous questions are made in this way. There is a person standing on the platform, an engine comes from this side and goes from this side. So when he is coming from here, what is the sign, what is the positive direction? He is the source, I am the observer. Sound is coming in this direction. So this is positive direction. Right? So engine has a speed of 20 meter per second, plus or minus. Now engine crosses me. What is the direction of sound? Yes. Now this becomes the positive. And engine is going this way. Now what is the velocity of engine? Minus 20. So once it is placed as plus 20, and once it will be placed as minus 20 in this formula, velocity of source. So when it is coming here, we will write it plus 20. When it is going there, minus 20. When we write it minus 20, this becomes plus and this becomes larger. The frequency becomes less. Naturally, it is going away. The frequency will become less. When it is coming here, the frequency will become large, because this is plus and this becomes minus, this becomes smaller. So that is the exact formula. And what we are doing, that was, yes, a shortcut if both are coming together or if both are going away. But in this case, both are going in the same direction, still they are coming close to each other. That is why that formula did not work. Understand? So go by the fundamental formula. It's also not very difficult. Only thing, all the time you will have to careful for sign convention. You can do that. Okay? So should we close it now? Please see this question. A wave is traveling. There is a traveling wave and there are four equations given to us. We have to find out which equation is correct. What is the data given? The first thing, notice, in which direction it is traveling? Positive x direction. Then what characteristic it gives you? Positive x direction. How can we find out positive x direction? Kx minus omega t. So which are the equations you would like to cancel? Pardon? B. This. Okay. Because this is moving in negative x direction. And that says positive x direction. Okay. Having displacement along y direction as 1 meter, wavelength x is equal to 2 pi meter. This is what? Wavelength. 2 pi meter. Where does wavelength appear in any wave equation? K. K is equal to what? 2 pi by lambda. Where is K found in the equation? The one which is multiplied with x. So what is the multiplicand of x? That should be how much? 2 pi upon 2 pi. 2 pi upon lambda is 2 pi. 2 pi upon 2 pi is equal to 1. So x should be multiplied with? Is there any equation? A. Wrong. Wrong. You got the answer. Do you want to try more? Why he has written this much? Frequency is how much? Where is the frequency found?
Omega.
Omega into T. Omega is multiple of T. What is, this is omega. This is omega. What is our omega? 2 pi upon frequency multiplied by 2 pi. So that comes to
2.
No pi. Here there is pi. Here there is pi. And this is 2. So this is the right. You got it? Correct? So this is how you use the characteristics of it. Okay. Just one more question. And I don't think I have to write it because it's a very long question. Please read it. It doesn't need calculation. It is only conceptual. It says, if we study vibration of a pipe open at both ends. What type of pipe?
Open.
Okay. Which of the following statement is not true? First statement, open end will be empty node. True or not true?
True.
Second, odd harmonics of the fundamental frequencies will be generated.
No.
All harmonics will be generated. C. All harmonics of the fundamental frequency will be generated. This is true. And pressure changes will be maximum at both ends. Yes or no? True or false?
False.
Because those are antinodes. At antinodes, what is maximum? Displacement. And what is not there?
Pressure
change. Right? So you can find out which are the two true and which are not true. Okay. Please note down another one. Listen. A source of unknown frequency gives 4 beats. How many?
4 beats.
When sounded with a source of known frequency of 250 hertz. Please note down, what is this data? With 250 hertz, how many beats?
4.
I will write it here. Further it says, a source of known frequency gives 4 beats when sounded with source of 250 hertz. The second harmonic of the source of unknown frequency gives 5 beats. This is given by unknown source, but which harmonic?
Second
harmonic. That gives how many beats?
5
beats. And the question says, okay. The second harmonic of the source of unknown frequency gives 5 beats when sounded with a source of frequency 513 hertz. There are two situations. The unknown frequency is what? Okay, let us once again. A source of unknown frequency gives 4 beats when sounded with a source of 250 hertz. Unknown frequency, new unknown. Right, with 250, how much it gives? 4 beats. The second line we have to read again. The second harmonics of the source, this source. The second harmonics of this source give 5 beats when sounded with a source of frequency 513 hertz. 5 beats. So the first harmonic gives how many beats?
4 beats.
The second harmonic gives?
5 beats.
Okay, this is with the source 250, this is with the source 513. Now, what we are supposed to find out here, what is the unknown frequency, new unknown. Okay, this very easy. We all know that second harmonic means what? Double of the first frequency, right? Now here, 250 hertz, 4 beats. What are the possibilities? Either 246 or 254. Two possibilities. This is nu minus 250 or 250 minus nu. Now it has become second harmonic 2 nu. Now 2 nu 513, and that gives 5 beats. What are the possibilities here? 513 minus 5. 5. 5. This happens with the second harmonic. Now find out. There should be one argument on which we should work. Trial error method. Let us suppose the first frequency is 246, unknown frequency. There are two values possible. If it is 246, what will be second harmonic of it? 246 multiplied by 2, how much it comes to?
492.
492 with 513, how many beats? More than 5? Not possible. Double it. 508. How many beats? So which is correct? Got it. Understand? So the basic frequency, there are only two possibilities. It may be either 246 or 254. We will try both of them. When we go for the second harmonic, then this is 492, which will give a large number of beats, which is not here. If we double this one, it gives 5 beats. That means this result is possible. We don't need to do this. Understand? So this is how it is done. So what is our option? 254 is the right option. Okay, let's close it now. We have done beats, we have done Doppler's effect, equation, and that velocity of sound, the lambda in that rope, all type of equations we have tried in all these numericals. Right? Thank you.